In this week's lab, we're going to become familiar with the geography of Earth's tectonic plates. As you learned in lecture, Earth's hard, rigid outer shell, its lithosphere, is broken into fragments or pieces of different sizes. We call those plates. Those plates are able to move different directions and different speeds relative to each other as they are carried on the convection currents in the underlying softer, more ductile asthenosphere. There's a figure similar to this in the lecture showing the different tectonic plates. You'll recall that there are two types of crust, continental crust and oceanic crust. Now the edges of tectonic plates don't necessarily correspond to transitions between oceanic and continental crust. Let's take North America as an example. The North American plate is composed of an area of continental crust, but also an area of adjoining oceanic crust that has been added to the eastern edge of the North American tectonic plate by seafloor spreading at the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. Although these are two different types of crust, they function as the same plate. They are moving, both the continental and oceanic crust is moving away from the Mid-Atlantic Ridge where new oceanic crust is being added to the eastern edge of the North American plate. Looking at the other tectonic plates, we see again that most plates are composed of a mixture of continental and oceanic crust. There are just a few plates composed only of oceanic crust. Now each plate is surrounded by different types of plate boundaries. Let's use the North American plate as an example again. To its east, we have a divergent boundary with the Eurasian plate and the African plate. Here, new oceanic crust is being made by seafloor spreading. Off the Oregon and Washington coasts, North America is convergent with a small plate of oceanic crust called the Juan de Fuca plate. Now remember that continental crust is thicker and more buoyant than oceanic crust. So when plates of continental and oceanic crust converge, the plate with continental crust overrides the thinner, denser oceanic plate. That process is called subduction. And in that process, the older, denser oceanic crust is recycled back into Earth's mantle, marked by a trench at the surface and a volcanic arc farther inland, built on the overriding plate above the depth where the subducting plate causes melting in the mantle. North America also has transform plate boundaries. It is transform with the Pacific plate, and that marks where the Pacific plate moves northward relative to the North American plate. You know that boundary more likely as the San Andreas Fault. North American plate also has a transform boundary with the Caribbean plate here on its southern edge. Again, each plate is surrounded by different types of plate boundaries. For example, we have a convergent boundary between the South American and Nazca plate, whereas the South American plate is divergent with the African plate. All the locations on the same plate will be moving in the same direction at the same velocity. Near the end of the lecture on the discovery plate tectonics, we had an image where we showed different GPS measured velocities for different places on different tectonic plates. For example, all the GPS stations on the Pacific plate are moving northwest at around 10 centimeters per year. This means that each location on the same plate is not moving relative to other locations on the same plate, but is moving relative to locations on adjacent plates that are moving in different directions or at different velocities. So in the exercise where you're asked to determine whether different cities are getting closer together, further apart, or show no change with respect to each other, you need to determine whether the cities are on the same plate, in which case they would show no change with respect to each other. If they're on different plates, you need to decide what type of plate boundary is in between them. Take, for example, New York and Paris. New York and Paris are on different tectonic plates on opposite sides of the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. Now, ridge is, of course, a divergent boundary. That means that over time, New York and Paris are getting farther apart as new oceanic crust is being added at the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, getting farther apart by about 4 to 6 centimeters per year. Cities on different plates with a convergent boundary between them will be getting closer together with time. Take, for example, Tokyo and Honolulu. Honolulu on the Pacific plate, moving northward. The Pacific plate is being subducted by the Eurasian plate. So as the Pacific plate is destroyed by subduction, Honolulu and Tokyo are getting closer together.